Good evening to all of you. Today we are going to study about designing a binary tree from the given traversal sequences. In our last lecture, we have seen the different algorithms for a binary tree traversal. Now, there are three different types of problem may be asked in the examination. The first one is type 1 problem, where you need to design a binary tree from given pre-order and in-order traversal sequence. To design a binary tree from given pre-order and in-order traversal sequence, we need to follow these steps. In step 1, first of all, we need to find the root node of the tree. How do you find the root node of the tree? From the given pre-order sequence, we can find the root node of the tree, because in pre-order sequence, we know that the root is always at the beginning. Now, after getting the root node of the tree, we can find the left child and right child of the root node from the given in-order traversal sequence. We need to first locate where is the root appears into the in-order traversal sequence. After that, the part which appears, the elements which appears on the left hand side of the root node are placed into the left subtree, whereas the elements which appears into the right subtree, right part of the root node is placed into the right subtree. In the last step, we actually repeat all the above steps till the last element is done. Let's see the first example of creating a binary tree from given pre-order and in-order sequence. So consider these two sequences are given to pre-order and in-order. To get the root node of the tree, we always refer pre-order sequence, because as we know, the root is always coming first into the pre-order traversal sequence. Whereas in in-order traversal sequence, the root may comes in between anywhere. So we can easily find A is the root node of this tree from given pre-order sequence. Then we draw A as a root node here. Once we get the root node, to find the left child and right child of the root node, we refer the in-order sequence and we check where A appears into the sequence. We found A here, correct? So once we get A, found A, the part which appears, the elements which appears on the left hand side of root node A will get placed into left subtree, and we draw it here. After that, the elements which appears on the right hand side of root node A, which gets placed into the right part of the tree. After getting the root left child and right child of the root node, we need to go to the third step, where we repeatedly follow above two steps to get the next root. Now, how to find the next root? Again, we refer the pre-order sequence. After A, there is an alphabet B. It means this is the next root for this tree. Now, we draw B here. And in the previous step, we have seen that if I make B as the root node here, it means that the elements which appears on the left hand side of root node B will get placed into the left subtree, whereas elements which appear on the right hand side gets placed into right subtree of the root node. Okay, but there are no elements on the left hand right hand side of the root node. That's why there is no right child here. Okay, after placing node B to its proper place, now we need to again find which is the next root after B. The next root is F from the pre-order sequence. Then we draw F as the root node. If I say F is the root node, it means that all the elements which comes on the right side goes to the right subtree of root node F, whereas there are no elements on the left hand side, so there is no left child for root node F. After placing node F to its proper place, the next root, again we go to the pre-order sequence. After F, Q is the next root. So if we make Q as the root node, Sn will go to the left subtree, whereas W will go to the right subtree of the Q. Now, after Q, the next root node is N from the pre-order sequence. Now, to place N to its proper place in this step, there is S on the left hand side and there is no right child to node N. We'll draw that. So after placing N to its proper place, this is the picture. Okay. So now, after N, S is the next node. And if you see this in this diagram, already s is placed and there are no left and right child remainder. So we discard that step. Then we'll go to next root w. W is also placed to its proper place. There is no left and right child remainder. Okay. The next node is g. Suppose if we make g as the node in this diagram, all the elements are appearing on the left hand side. It means all the element goes to the left subtree of the root node g as per the sequences given. Okay. After g, k is the root node. If I make k is the root node, all elements towards right goes to right part and all elements towards left are going to the left part. But there is no left subtree for node k. After k, from the pre-order sequence, l is the next root. If we make l as the root node in this diagram, if you see, if I make l as the root node, m is appearing on the left hand side, so it goes to left part, whereas z will go to the right subtree. Once we do that, our all the elements are placed to its proper place, and this is the final binary tree for the given two traversal sequences.